on the function, everybody says A means 1. So then, by doing that, what are we going to get here? This function that we have here is going to only involve three variables, sub 4, that we established. So that way, what is the application of this? So what do we use? Why do we want to use this expansion? Application is in FPGA, no? That we talked about last time. So what was an FPGA?
Field programmable
gate array, no? So what are these? These are chips, no? They come ready with cells that you can store your function in, no? And what technology does it use? Does it use ROM or does it use PLA and PAS? It's based on ROM, right? So lookup tables, they just, what you are storing them is going to be the truth table of the function. So now these lookup tables that you have in FPGAs, they don't have big sizes. So they can be 3 input lookup tables or 4 input lookup. So in order, and so if you have functions which have, suppose you have 3 input lookup tables and you want to implement a 4 variable function in them, so you cannot do it, right? So then in that case, you apply the Shannon's theorem to it, and so that now your functions are going to have 3 variables. Then that way you can fit your this function in each lookup table that you want, and then you can implement. That's the application of this examples that we looked at. So if you have a 5 variable function, so this function, it has 5 variables, A, B, C, D, E. So what we have are lookup tables that they have how many variables? 4 variables. So in order to use this FPGA in particular one, what we do, we apply the Shannon's theorem. So it's going to be A prime times the function evaluated at 0 for A, and then plus A times function evaluated 4 at A being 1. So that way now we have 4 variable functions. So each of these, we can put it in one of these lookup tables. 4 variables, and then A is going to go on there. One multiplexer. Okay. If A is 0, you're going to select F0. If A is 1, you're going to select F1. Yeah, so this Shannon's theorem is going to be F1. Okay, any question on that? For your second test, for sure you're going to have application of Shannon's theorem. So learn what Shannon's theorem is and how you apply it. Okay. But now let's look at an example. Yes.
So that's chapter 9, though?
Yes, we are still in chapter 9.
But so we have chapter 9 included in this test?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
The next test is going to be over chapter 5, 7, 8, 9.
Okay.
So they have given us this function that has 5 variables, A, B, C, D, E. So we have this 5 variable function, which is C, D prime E, plus C, D, E, plus A prime D prime E, plus A prime D prime E, E prime, plus B, C. So they are saying this function, we want to implement this in an FPGA. 5 variables, so we have to get rid of 2 of the variables in order to implement it in the 3 variable lookup tables that we have. So in order to do that, we apply the Shannon's theorem. So now we get f of a is equal to e being equal to, so we want to expand it with respect to 2 variables, a and b. So then we are going to write all the different combinations for a and b. So first we start with a prime b prime, and then we go to our function and substitute in our function where a is 0 and b is 0. I'm going to write this here, so I'm letting a be 0 and b be 0. So I go to here, let a be 0, b be 0. So the first term doesn't have a and b. A or b be right. The second term doesn't have it either. The third term has a prime. So a is 0, then a prime is going to be 1, 1. So then what do we get? So now we are letting a be 0 here, so what do we get? So that's going to be 1, so we get 1 b from d, and then b, c. Okay, so that's the first one.
Wait, what about the b? Do we have to substitute?
We are letting a be 0 and b be 0. So let's go to here. So if you let a be 0, what do we get? A prime becomes 1, 1. So we get B prime D. And then A, B, 0, we get B prime D, B prime. Oh, and also we have B. B is going to be 0, so that's going to be 1, so that's D, B prime. And then B is 0, so that term goes. And then we are going to look at A prime B. So in this case, we are going to let the function evaluate the function when a is 0 and b is 1. So the substitute and see what we get. So we get c d prime e plus c d e. And then a is 0, so a prime is going to be what? 1. So we get d prime e. This term we have b being 1, so that term goes to 0. And then b is 1, and a we don't have. So and then the rest of it, so we have A, B prime. So the next case is A, B prime. So we let A be 1 and B be 0. So in the function, let's evaluate 2. So, and then A is 0, so A is 1, so A prime is 0. So what's going to happen to that term? That goes away. And then for this one, the same thing. That goes away. And B is 0, so that goes away. So that's the term that we need. And also, we have to take care of when A is 0, 1, and B is 1. Okay, so then, that will be evaluated. So A is 1, so A prime is going to be what? 0. So that term goes to 0, right? A is 1, so that goes to 0, and then B is 1, so then plus C. So that's the expansion of this function with respect to variables A and B. And then what you can do, go inside each of these and try to minimize it. So you can just leave it like that. Okay, now let's do the same problem. Now expand, we want to expand f about the variables b and c. Okay, so now in this case, what are we going to do? So f of a, b, c, d, e. B prime, C prime. So we are letting B be 0 and C be 0. in 0, first term goes, second one goes, right? And then third one, do we have B or C in it? We don't, so we don't. And then this second one has P being 0, so P prime is going to be what? 1. And then C doesn't have, so it's going to be A prime, D, E prime. B, C, D, C is 0, so that goes away. And then we, let's take a look at B prime C. So B is 0, C is 1. So, and so on. So C is 1, so we get D prime E. C is 1, we get B, D. And then A prime, D prime, E. And then we have here B prime, so that's 1, so A prime, E, E prime. B is 0, so that turns over. So then what do I need to include now? What is next?
It's B, C prime.
Okay, so B, C prime. Now we want B, B1, and C, B, C. So we go to here. B is 1 and C is 0. C is 0, those two terms they go away. And then this one doesn't have B or C. This term has B prime, so B prime is going to be 1. B is 1, so B prime is 0, right? That goes away. B is 1, so C is 0, so that goes away. And then we have BC. Okay, so BC, we are letting B be 1 and C be 1. So C being equal to 1, what are we going to get with, from this term? B prime E. And then C being 1, so we have B, E. And then this one doesn't have a B. And then DP is 1, so B prime is 0, so that term goes away. So that's C being 1, so this one, both are 1s, and then we get D. So then what we want to do is expand it now with respect to A and C. So let's see what we do. Who wants to come and do that?
I'm expanding it about A and C.
A and C.
Which is B prime E. three are gone. And then A prime, that one's gone. And then C.
So all everything, so you in the Bronson, you write C.
Zero.
Uh-huh. And then plus AC. So now you let A be 1 and C be 1. So you're letting C be 1. So the C
will you pull a C out of those?
So you just
Sorry.
It's a good idea to write the 1 and 1 under the AC so that when you want to substitute, sometimes you don't see it. And that helps you to keep track of when you look at A prime and you see that zero, then you know A is 0 for when you want to substitute it on the AC. Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
Okay, so now. So if you look at this AC that he did, that's a better choice, isn't it? Because now in implementing that, we need only 3 LUTs, while the others, we need 4 of them, right? So then that's a better choice. The optimum solution for it. So having that, now we want to draw and see what. In the next part of the problem, they're saying the expanding it, yes.
Is there any way to know that that's the easiest way by looking at it, or do you just have to trial and error?
Trial and error. Oh. Yeah, you have to go through all the cases and see which one is the
best.
Okay. That's what we do. Thanks. So now we want to implement this with LUTs and with 4-to-1 multiplexers. So let's see what we do. So now we are using the one that he did, which is with respect to the ALC. Okay, so in that one, then we need 3 LUTs. So these are lookup tables. So in this problem, they were telling us that this particular FPGA has 3 input lookup tables. So that's what we are doing. We're going to use 3 of those, and then we're going to use a 4-to-1 multiplexer also as given. And on the multiplexer, we're going to put the A and C. That's when the ones that expanded with respect to the variable. And then the rest of it, the VCD that he, the AC expansion that he has there, his functions that you see there, in each of those quantities, what variable do they all have? Indeed. Right, so for his F0, so what was the problem? What I'm calling F0 is what? Whatever he had in the first one, which is D prime E plus E prime D E prime D, right? That's our F0. So that's what we are going to put in this LUT, that function.
E prime.
Okay, then what is his F1? The next one that he has in the parentheses is E prime E. Plus D, E. Is the other one D prime E as well?
Yeah.
Okay, so we can drop that one, right? Okay, what is the next one? B prime D, E prime, is that right? And what is the last one? B. Okay, so that's our F1. And what is F3? F3 is D prime E, plus, is that D? plus BD? Okay. So those are our functions. So those are what we are going to put in these. And what we are going to store in these lookup tables are the truth table. So how can we get the truth table of these? What is this term? So F0, D prime E. So D prime E, that's going to be 1, right? And also, when it's 1, 0, 1, that's going to be 1, right? So that's entering that function into that root. Is that right? Okay, now let's do B prime DE. So B prime DE, so that's 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1. And the rest are these. So easily, we can enter these. So in this LUT, what we have stored, so remember, the FPGAs are based on ROMs, right? So in ROM, you store the truth table, right? The function with 0 and 1. And CPLD, what was the basis of that? So how do they build the CPLDs?
PLA?
PLA or
PLA.
So that way we can have
yes. The F0, sub 0, I think that's a B prime D E prime.
Okay. I don't know, I'm just trying to copy from it.
Yeah. Sorry, my handwriting is really.
Isn't what he has there?
Yeah.
If that's E prime, then it's going to be 0, 1, 0. And that's, thank you. Okay, so that's what is stored in that lookup table. Then F1. So if you want to enter F1, what do we have? So that's going to be 0, 1. So we are looking for 0, 1. And then also 101. DE is going to be about 11 here. And then 11. Okay. And then we want B prime DE prime. So that's 010. 0107. And then BD is going to be about 11 here. Then also 0 or
1, 1, 1.
Okay, so we took care of that one. So if you don't do it that like this, what else can you do? You just give the input. You just evaluate your function at different values, right? So you let, for example, for this case, we have B be 0, D be 0, and E be 0, and we evaluate your function. Okay. And you do the same thing for F3. So F3, we have 0, 1 here, 0, 1, and then 1, 0, 1. DE is going to be 1, 1, so 0, 1, and then 1, 1, and BD. Going to be 110. So these are the three functions which are stored in the lookup table.
How come we chose to use the functions from A, doing AC instead of one of the other?
Okay. The reason is that you are using one less lookup table.
So if we're asked to do this on a test, do we go through every single option eliminating two?
If they ask you to find the best solution, yes.
they say just to do eliminate AC,
then
you just
do AC
and just work it out. Okay.
What you want to do here is to design an 8-to-1 multiplexer using 2 4-to-1 multiplexers and 1 inverter and 2 tri-state buffers. Try it and let's see if we can do it. Thank you. can think of this. Say, this is what we want to get, an 8-to-1 multiplexer. So 8-to-1 multiplexer, you know that it has 3 control lines and it has 8 inputs. So you're selecting one of these inputs to be outputted, right? So now what they have given you is that you have 2 4-to-1 multiplexer, right? So then on those 2 4-to-1 multiplexers, what control line should you put on? So if you look at the ABC, right, you see the B and C are the same, right? So you can connect B and C to the 2 control lines of the 4-to-1 multiplexer. But how can you build this A? So then that A that you need, you're going to build it with your tri-state buffer and one inverter. So try to figure that out. Did anyone get it yet? Our tri-state buffer here, right? And then you put A here, and then if you want to pick I0 through I3, your A's are going to be what? 0, right? So if you put 0 on this, that's going to go through inverter from 1 here, so you're selecting that.
Oh, 2, 3,
so
0
is not going to select this one, so that, those are going to be outputted. If you put 1 on this now, this one is not going to be selected, but this is going to be selected, right? Then whatever you have here is going to be output, then I4 to I7 can be output. Okay, so with that, we are done with chapter 9. So now let's decide when you want to have your test. So your homework on chapter 9 is due Monday.